This presentation is about neighborhood. In the early 90s, Clarence Perry gives this concept, so that is about the neighborhood concept. He gave this concept just because for introducing this community aspect. Because in the right now condition, as you can see, that the people are living in the smart cities, in the metro cities, there is the well-developed instruments are there, technologies are there, but one thing is a lacking portion that cannot be found out in the smart city as well as in the congested area, that is called the community. The community gathering, the community built-up thing, which is involved by the Clarence Perry theory that includes the neighborhood planning. So the concept of the neighborhood, that is the small unit, the neighborhood just you can say as a small unit which serve the local community and encourage them to foster a neighborhood spirit and relationship, which obviously you can see that lost in the modern city life. Now the neighborhood planning is an attempt to form various physical units of a residential area in which people belonging to a particular rank of life settle or stay. It is the intention of a town planner to rejuvenate the valuable idea of a neighborhood which have been lost in a busy uncondos city life. So we are putting each and every physical component and making a group of that component and provide it near to the one community and build up the whole city in the community wise. Not on the land use wise, not on the area wise, but we are developing the total area and control the total unit with the help of the neighborhood. Each and every physical component should be located as it is to give a priority in a human life. Some importance are there that why we have to provide, we should provide neighborhood planning in our smart city, our modern city. So first of all, that it will give you total welding. Welding is a sense total combination, a good kind of a combination of both elements, social element as well as the cultural life. That is the lacking portion in the above modern city. Next thing, that it develops a community spirit. People try to live together, people are getting more and more closer to each other, people are getting each other community things, people getting each other's activities, and that will give you nothing but a community build-up with which people will live in the healthy environment. Next, that is the better blending of a population structure, because if you provide the neighborhood units, the population are also diverted into the each and every neighborhood. That one neighborhood contains 5,000 population. So each and every neighborhood will contain 5,000 population. So there will be no over congested in one typical location. Each and every population that will be easily segregated in the all over your city. It's not that that one portion will contain the more population over congested area and other area that will have the lesser population. So with the help of a neighborhood, you can give the total equal distribution of population also. And there is also good blend of the population. That means in one neighborhood you may find out lower public also as well as higher category person also. There will be the economical weaker section also, and there will be double higher income group also. And the main thing, that we are getting with the help of the neighborhood, that is the easy movement to each and every part. Because as we can see that if you want to go from your residential portion to one garden, you have to take your vehicle and after that you may reach at that another location. But in the neighborhood unit, you can reach to the location, the nearer location. That will be too easy because in one neighborhood unit, you will find each and every physical unit that is important in your life. So this one is the your neighborhood concept and importance of the neighborhood in the human life as well as in the town plan. Principles of the neighborhood planning, number of principles are there. So whenever you provide or whenever you put the planning, whenever you making the neighborhood, these are the number of principles that should be followed. And each and every principle should be followed, then and then it's called your neighborhood unit, as you cannot tell it the neighborhood. Okay. So each and everything that is defining here, that will be the part of the neighborhood and that should be followed at the compulsory portion. So first of all, the size of the neighborhood. So it is a limited area. You cannot go beyond larger and larger area. It is has the boundary, it has the limitation. So the size should not be too much or not too much deep. So size should be 1 to the 1.5 square kilometer area. So if you draw one circle of one diameter, then it's also okay. And in that radius portion, each and everything should be followed. And the population should be 2000 to the 5000. It should not be more than a 5000. And whenever this population is divided, it is divided on the hierarchy portion. So your total town, that would be divided into the sector of the 10,000 population, and that sector will be further divided into the your neighborhood units. That unit will contain 2,000 to 5,000 population. So maybe one neighborhood unit contain 3,000 population, or one another neighborhood unit will contain 5,000 population. It may vary. It's not like that each city have each and every neighborhood with an equal population. No, there will be the difference in the population, but the thing is the population should be 2000 to the 5000 only. The boundary. You have to define the boundary of your neighborhood unit so you can easily identify your neighborhood and easily modify as well as easily maintain your tables, your neighborhood units. So take main roads as your boundary area. So whenever the main road are passing through, the area within the your main road, that will be your neighborhood unit. That is the boundary. After that, the protective strip. Main road is not giving you the protection. It's not giving you the protective strip. Protective strip, that is the kind of a green belt. Green belt, now what is the green belt? So green belt is provided at the boundary of the area for providing the limitation of the growth, for the limitation of the expansion. That means in the protective strip, you cannot develop further or after the green belt. So in the protective strips, neighborhood have minor green belt. In minor green belt, there are park, playground or future road widening area, open land, barren land, which give you the green belt area, which will define that this is the limit. We should not develop beyond this limit. Next, internal streets. Internal streets are specially designed for the school public, for the children, for the local public to transport from one area to the another area by walk or by the local vehicle only. The internal streets are not provided for the heavy transportation. Heavy transportation is only on the boundaries, only on the main roads. They are not give the permission to go on the your internal streets. So internal streets give you the proper safety to the school children and to the people living in the neighborhoods. And it will give you the easy accessibility to the local markets, to the local shops and the local community center. Next principle, that is the layout of a building. So as I said that in the neighborhood unit, there is a totally gathering, totally blending of population. So in the layout of a building, each and every kind of a building you may find out that shoot to the income group. So there will be lower income group housing, middle group income housing, as well as higher and double higher income group housing also are there. So that will give you the social stability that in one typical area, in the area of 1 to 1.5 square kilometer, each and every income group can stay and have the benefit of neighborhood. Next, shopping center. So whenever you provide the shopping center in the neighborhood, that should be located at the junction. So whenever you provide the shopping center at the junction, different population from a different area will be gathered at one junction and do the shopping. So for that reason only, the shopping centers are provided at the traffic junction, and this traffic junction should be at the circumference of your neighborhood unit. It should not be at the center of your neighborhood unit. Always shopping centers are provided and the boundary area of your neighborhood, and it should provided at the junction only. After then the community centers, most probably the community center is that area where each and every people will come together and celebrate the function as well as celebrate the festivals. So for that reason, the community center should always be at the center of your neighborhood unit. It should not be at the one corner or the another corner or at the junction. It should be at the totally on the center portion of your neighborhood unit. And the last one, the facilities, that which different facilities you should provide it. So number of facility you can provide it in it, but the basic facilities that are the primary school, you can also provide secondary school, you should provide dispensaries, temples, clubhouses, sports center, clinics, hospitals, milk booth, police station. So whenever there are those requirements, you can provide the different number of facilities that should be near to the population, that should be near to the neighborhood unit. So these are the number of principles of the manage that should be followed whenever you plan a neighborhood plan. So these are the main thing of the neighborhood. If you get knowledge of this many principles, you will easily make a neighborhood unit, and this is the most beneficial kind of a thing, that is one major kind of a smart thing that has the smart innovation, smart technology with the community gathering. After that, the next features of the neighborhood unit. So which are the principles? That principle is nothing but give you the features of the neighborhood unit. So how you can differentiate neighborhood with other kind of a planning. So these are the different features that is find out in the NHC neighborhood unit. So whenever you planning a neighborhood unit, the 10% of your totally land parcel that is allotted for park and playgrounds. So in neighborhood unit, there are no congestions, there are open spaces for the recreational purpose. After that, each and every side are equally divided. It's not like that one area is too far from the center and one corner is too much nearer to the center. No, each and every portion is equally divided and at the equally distance with the your center of the area. After that, the boundary. As I said, the boundary is the main road, but we are providing with the minor green gate. Okay. Next, the population that should be 2000 to the 5000, the size that should be 1 to the 1.5 square kilometer, shopping center that should be at the periphery only at the traffic junction. For what? For each and every person will be gathered or will reach at that location. Next, public facility. Each and every public facility should be within the 1 kilometer in the central space. The reason is that 1 kilometer, you can say, is the walking distance. If you want to go from your residence to the public facility, you can easily go by walk on. You don't need to take any public vehicle or you don't need any your private vehicle also. You can go by walk. And the neighborhood unit is mainly designed for this purpose only, that you don't need vehicle transportation. Each and everything is at the convenient distance. You can go to each and every places. It is the market, shopping center, or the dispensary, or the school, or the community center. That is at the walkable distance. That is the main advantage or a main feature of the neighborhood. And another thing, that each and everything is a plant. That is a proper sanitation, proper utility services, and the people will be live in the totally habitant condition. And the last one, the internal street. It will provide it with the or sufficient width that you can easily transport by the vehicle. As well as footpath is also given, so you can easily access to each and every portion of your neighborhood unit. So these are the features that you may find out in any kind of a neighborhood unit. Here the neighborhood components are there, as well as the figure is also here, in which you can easily find out that shopping center is at the corner portion. Number of residential portions are there, flat are also there, school are there, not one school, but three number of schools are provided. At the corner portion, open spaces are there, park and playground are also there, which is nearer to the your school area, because when there is a school, we require playground near to the school. And as you can see in this image, that in the central portion, there is your public building. That is for the, as well as the community hall is also given at the central portion. So, residential public from each and every portion will be come together in the center of your area. So, this is your neighborhood component, and this is how your neighborhood unit should be look like. These are the land distribution of the percentage wise, that is nothing but the land use distribution. Land use distribution, that how much percentage of land will be used in which kind of activity. So there are the single family building, two family building. Single family building should be 35%, two family that should be 5%, and flat should be 15%. So totally 55% of the your area that should be of your residential building one. After then, 15% is allowed for the open spaces, for the park, for the playground. 20% for the circulation purposes, for the internal road. This 20% is for the internal road, not for the external. After that, the public building that should be of a 5%. Shop, community hall, school, etc. Whichever activity you want to provide, you may provide it in the 5%. So here your total 100% will be distributed. This image is given by the Clarence Perry, who is the founder of a neighborhood unit. In this figure, you may find out that each and every detail is given, that there are the highways passing through, between the highway, there is one neighborhood. The radius is also given, that in this much of a radius area, you may find out the residential also, internal streets are there, parks, playground, gardens, community center, residential area, as well as the shopping centers are also there. So this is the all neighborhood unit concept which should be followed for the easy development for the community builder. So here your topic neighborhood is completed, and this is too much beneficial for the town planners. It is the modern technology. So whenever you make a town planning or make any kind of a plan of a town, you may try to put neighborhood unit concept for the community builder, because alternatively, whichever planning, whichever modernization we are doing, that is for just public only. So for the public, community should be there, community builder should be there, and for that thing, neighborhood is the main thing that should be accepted. So here it is, the neighborhood concept is completed. Thank you so much.